from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business, whole team got wins in the wheel suspended. I told them what I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. Ayy, I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if he drop, I just hit my dance. I was popped, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I gold it again and again. Who was the dummy that died? I'm the coldest around, but he folding again and again. I'm in the what? I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You with us or what? Keep it running.
We are pleased as always to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Carolina Panthers and the Atlanta Falcons. And this carries into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at the 23-yard line.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. The play fake. Ray. And he gets this one to Ridley, complete. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is third and 9. From the gun, Ray. And that is incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
By Dante Jackson.
Yeah, last week in the loss, 5 punts as he gets this one away. And here comes Westbrook. It's a 41-yard punt, but just a net of 31 following the run back. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. To pass, here's Jordan Love. Steps away to his left. Got his man, Robbie Anderson. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. A gain of 6 there on first. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
looking middle, and it's incomplete. Good coverage that time by the linebacker, Deion Jones.
And that's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties, and he's able to knock that one away.
Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. Working out of the gun, Love. And he finds a man. It's McCaffrey. And he takes this thing way down into Atlanta territory. So with the pass being completed, they'll go ahead and take that instead.
Nothing extra to be gained. Pass interference at the spot, completed the pass. That was your play. So it might as well have not even had the penalty.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. First carry for Christian McCaffrey. He takes us down to about the 12 for a gain of three.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Second and seven.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Out of the shotgun, it's Love. Escaping the pressure right. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
And it's third down.
Here's Love. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
Quick throw complete, and he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Curtis Samuel, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. And this will be good to give the Panthers a 7-0 lead.
Makes the score Panthers 7, Falcons nothing.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line. So the same result, and he opted for the touchback.
25-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. Here's Gurley now, out of the gun. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 15 yards on the play, first down. Now look, that wasn't a huge game, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched it more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
Gurley again here on first down. Takes to midfield, but no further. Just a yard there.
He's brought down.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, They also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver, and it's third down.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine.
Right there, 54, right there, 54 miles.
We ain't giving up nothing to shut up.
Operating from the gun, Ray. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
Here's Sterling Hoffrichter now. They'll boot it away from about his 35. The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complementary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance. If they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They start on the ground with McCaffrey. And able to get it across the 10 to the 15. Try to escape the shadow of their goalpost. That helped. 10 yards. First down.
I guess it's good we can't really read the mind of the defensive coordinator now, huh?
Had him pin back there deep, give up that run. Can't be happy.
Yeah, whatever's in his mind right now, we probably couldn't say over the air.
Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end, complete. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. He got 29 yards that time. First down, this is McCaffrey, and he'll take this one up close to about the 45. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try and keep a defense honest.
You mean, or else he'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
On second down, McCaffrey pushing forward for three up to the 48.
Christian McCaffrey.
We've called a lot of games, but we don't normally talk about inside linebackers being that fleet of foot, do we?
No, he was able to get outside there to make that play.
Yeah, and you know what makes them faster? Their ability to read plays, understand what offenses are trying to do, and put themselves in proper position.
5 men in the secondary now for the Falcons on third down. Play action this time with Love. And looking for Andrews, but this is intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And he'll return this ball across midfield to the 47-yard line. That's now a second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. On first down, Ray over the middle, and it's incomplete. The intended target was Calvin Ridley, and now it's second down.
That was nice work there defensively to force incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet, so they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
Now on second down, this is Gurley. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game, and that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. And he's got this down to the 35. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Seven, Falcons nothing.
To the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They run out of the shotgun with Gurley. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line.
Dante Jackson.
The former LSU Tiger Dante Jackson on the stop.
On the pickup. Second and 6 at the Panthers' 31-yard line.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. From the gun, Ray. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked off by Troy Pride. The 20, 10, and he will bring this one back. It's a pick 6 for a Panther touchdown.
Well, it certainly looked to me like he tapped into the quarterback's thought process there. But I'm hearing more and more when I go around the league, defenders sitting in on quarterback meetings trying to learn more about how they think so they can be in the right position to be in the right spot, as he was there to pick that one off and take it all the way back for a touchdown.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And last time, decent field position through the pick 6, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try it.
The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down.
Well, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple of scores, Brandon, and guess what? I think they're just going to pin their ears back now and get upfield and get after the quarterback.
Been such an impressive first half to get that lead. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Operating from the gun, Ray. Taken down, back at his own 7. Derrick Brown able to get in there for his 2nd sack of the afternoon.
Okay, let's go back a little bit and see if my schooling comes to the front. What's that old saying? Those who forget the lessons of history are doomed to repeat them. That's the same guy who's gotten back-to-back sacks. I think a double team may be in order.
The Falcons on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and forever.
Right there.
54. Back to throw, Ray. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21.
14 yards, but they're still well shy of a first as that leads to fourth down.
They dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Now a hit and a loose football. And the Falcons grab it. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops.
I remember sitting in special teams meetings, and at some point during the meeting, the coach would always say, you better treat this one just like you're playing offense or defense. It's a big part of the game. And we just saw evidence of why right there with that fumble.
Yeah, fumble on the punt, and after it was turning up to be a pretty decent return.
Yeah, a really nice return. They were going to be set up okay, and the offense would feel good running onto the field. And now the defense has to trot out there and try and slow them down.
On first down, it's Gurley. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39.
The ball carrier.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Here's Gurley. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
A first chance in the red zone for the Falcons now. First and 10 at the 19.
Watch the twist. Watch the
twist. They run. It's Gurley. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Sometimes in the run game, you can make the argument that quickness beats size. And how about the example right here?
To throw on second down, Ray. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
The Falcons on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and 11. From the gun, Ray. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe.
Well, that's a down and distance coaches always talk about trying to avoid, isn't it? I mean, that's third and long. And you just know they're pinning their ears back and coming after him. Sometimes even with extra pressure.
And he knew that. I mean, he knew they were coming. He just fumbled it.
Yeah, he knew it. The offensive line knew it. Everyone did. Yet the pressure was still there, and he ended up coughing it up.
Now a run with McCaffrey. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
Brought down.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Love from the gun. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Didn't they tell us in our meetings that they needed to account for him on each and every play?
You think? A guy of his caliber? So how does a guy like him get that wide open?
That usually means there's a tire breakdown on what the coverage was. Everyone thought they were doing something and they were supposed to be doing something else. But bottom line is, no matter what, you have to know where he is and cover him on every play.
It's a Carolina first down on a gain of 16. From the gun, Love gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey, and down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down. He's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and that'll bring up second down.
Now, that was an excellent run, and when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block, but the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've kind of hit the jackpot there.
They will throw again here with Jordan Love. Flushed, fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. And the Falcons grab it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, give some credit to the defense. They forced the big play, knocked the ball free from him. But that's a cardinal sin by the quarterback. Know where you are on the field. And he just gave up at a minimum 3 points.
And instead of getting down, takes the contact. The turnover ensues. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, you have periods devoted in practice just for that, because everyone knows how vital it is to put points on the board when you've entered that part of the field. And to come away with nothing, that's difficult for a team to handle.
And difficult, and now we'll see if they can make it less difficult on themselves on this drive. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10.
He's crossing. He's checking crack. Check. Check. Check.
Here comes carry number 10 for Gurley. And he will lose yardage on the play. Back at his own 19-yard line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
One. Brings up third down and 11.
Third down, Ray trying to lay one up deep and unable to connect. Incomplete. Give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
They've had multiple opportunities on offense and still haven't scored any points. Felt like they wanted to loosen things up, throw it downfield, and see if maybe they could get a big play and a quick strike.
And here's Hoffrichter now, the punter, as he sends this one away. And this one will be down by a member of the kicking team at about the 40-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 40-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And so close to hitting pay dirt last time, fumbling down near the goal line. Now, how does that affect their psyche this time around?
It's a tester, that's for sure, because to be that close and come away with no points is really disappointing, not just for the guys on offense, but the defensive players too, who thought, hey, we're gonna put some points up and have a little momentum going. They've got to find a way to just get it out of their minds, let it go,
short-term memory,
and move on to the next series.
Love now to pass on first down. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. So it goes as a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. 15 yards on the play, first down. Play fake. Here's Love. And this will be incomplete. A physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
And normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
Here's second and 10 now from about the 32. Throwing again. Love taking a shot for Samuel. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. First and goal, and gosh, points here. A chance maybe to put this thing away before halftime. Again, it's Love. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. DJ Moore. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead.
Lining up for the point after.
The touchdown all set up by the big play one snap before, but they finish it off here with a shorter completion, this time for the score.
I like how they stuck with what got them there, right? The big pass play, got the momentum going, right? That's what you created with a play like that, and you come right back with another pass play to finalize things off.
The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Looking to throw. Ray airing it out, looking for Ridley. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 11. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on-the-job training. So he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
He's going to look deep for more. He's got a man complete. 20, 10, touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore as the first half is winding down. And the Panthers, they widen their lead.
Well, this is exactly where I expect teams to take a shot. Right after a turnover, you count on the defense being a little bit jumbled coming out on the field, maybe catch them back on their heels, and that's exactly what they did there. They threw it downfield, and really created a big play.
Yeah, you said jumbled. They were the definition of jumbled defensively. One play and into the end zone.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation.
Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Brian Burns picks up his second sack of the afternoon. They come up on second and long, and the pass protection just has not been there this afternoon. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Panthers out in front, and they will get the football first. Second half action underway. Taken about 7 yards deep. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
22-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here. And flags come in as he gets forward for about 3 yards. And let's check on the call. That time, the right guard sending him backwards.
And so many different types of guys rotate in on the defensive line now, depending on situations. You can get the bulky guy, the fast guy. No matter what, though, you can't hold him.
On second down, here's the option. And the ball comes out. Love lost it. And the Falcons grab it. And a first and goal coming up here inside the 10-yard line. A little careless with the football, and he also had a fumble loss last week, didn't he?
He certainly did, and when I'm watching him play, the one thing that comes to mind is always remember, traffic, turbulence, people around you, two hands. Get two hands on the ball. Grip it tight. I know it looks cool to have it in one hand, but put it away, tuck it away, because you've got to take care of the ball.
On first and goal, Gurley. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
I see a shake of the head as he gets up, and you've got to imagine he's thinking, guys, you got to help me out. He's hoping his team can read his thoughts because he definitely needs some assistance.
They'll try again on second and goal after going backwards to the 12. They'll stick to the ground game with Gurley. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
Now third and goal.
From the gun, Ray. Strong coverage by Carolina. And on we go to fourth down.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
I'm kind of surprised by that they kicked the field goal. I guess you get some points, but this deficit third quarter, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't either. Yeah, I'm with you on that one. When you're down that much, kicking a field goal, does it feel a little bit maybe waving the white
waving
flag?
The white. Just want to get out of here.
Yeah, I think you got to go ahead and try and get some bigger points on the board.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
I wish so much. I try to keep it late. I wish so much about all miss. No backboard.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field?
Accelerating, and off he goes. Touchdown, Carolina. Christian McCaffrey, 76 yards. And this offense continues to pour it on. And that run massively increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
And break out your calculator, partner, because his yards per carry went up significantly, right? Big-time jaunt all the way to the end zone.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Start the drive here with an end around. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
Well, that play looks familiar because we saw them working on it in practice this week. And for a lineman trying to block on this play, they love when they get the defense moving in one direction. And when they try and change directions, it's a lot easier to pick them up and ward them off.
Now they'll toss to Gurley left. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
I know the speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine.
I got you. 58 to my
60 Bobcat. Back to throw. Ray. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 46. And a great return here gets this one all the way down to the 26-yard line. Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
McCaffrey on the toss right. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. And pretty good running as he'll be close to a first down at the Falcons 14. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Here's McCaffrey. And this carry terminated at the 8-yard line. Good stick skill showing the power, but just not much room to operate. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4.
Brings up second and 4.
Maneuver his way down to about the 7. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3.
But when you go from 2nd and 4 to 3rd and 3, that just tells you who won that battle on the last play, huh?
Yeah, first round went to the offense, second round the defense.
for the Falcons. 5 men in the secondary, now on third. Love now. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete.
Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
Only two on the screen pass there, and it'll be fourth down.
Fourth down.
Joey Sly on now for the Panthers.
From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And his kick is good. And that will just add three more to a lead that's already out of hand. A good drive gets them inside the five, but they could not punch it in.
And credit the defense, too. Make sure that that happens, because that was the old bend but don't break approach. Make sure they contained them when they absolutely had to and forced the field goal attempt that went through.
At their own 20-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to this off. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Brian Burns getting him once again, his third sack of the afternoon.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness of that defensive line is eating them alive.
Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18.
Right there, 54, right there, right there.
On the counter, Gurley. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Just a one-yard loss that time, but that's not what they needed. Now they're dealing with a third and long.
Third down.
These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Again, they run with Gurley, and he'll get this one up to about his 14. Just a two-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on fourth down.
For the Falcons.
And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Westbrook now on the return. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And the Panthers will take over in terrific field position. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. This is McCaffrey. And he'll take this one down to the 36.
Christian McCaffrey.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. And pretty good running as he'll be close to a first down at the Falcons 30. It's a gain of 6, moves him to a manageable 3rd-and-2 situation.
A gain of 6 yards. And it's third down.
So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've played 3 quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. The Panthers on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd-and-2. Operating from the gun. Love into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 25. And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown.
The kicker on.
This game's still fairly well in hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell and just run the football?
I think you have to, but you also have to tell your backs, make sure you're really protecting the football, because you're going to run into a stacked defensive front, which is why they were throwing the football before, trying to make sure they just get their backs, you know, really beat up in that situation. Now, good luck to them.
With it on the return now, here's Westbrook. Oh, and now he pulls him over.
And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
At their own 28-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
He's got daylight, the 30. And he takes this thing way down into Atlanta territory. A big play there for Carolina. 65 yards on the ground. Well, that didn't take long. One play, and we're already looking at a first and goal situation. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. A nice pickup of six there to get him closer to the end zone, and it'll be second and goal.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now.
Second and goal from the one.
They go with the keeper. And he is not going to get in as the big bodies stop him at the one. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a third down.
Almost want to go Shakespeare here. My kingdom for a yard. Quarterback snake, nothing doing.
Better be careful. Shakespeare might sue you.
Yeah, he might come get me, right? Good luck with that, Bard.
Third and goal as they look to pour some more salt in the wound. On the ground, McCaffrey fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. Even though they've got this big advantage, Charles, they are not taking their foot off the gas pedal right now.
Well, I think what we're seeing is the result of all their great preparation and great practice time during the week. And even though it seems like this is a great chance to pull people back and maybe, you know, not try and score a few more times, they don't want to do that. I think they're enjoying what they're seeing, the collective effort, and they want to play it all the way out.
Joey Sly to kick off for Carolina.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
5-yard line.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Now Gurley. And very little running room there. He did get a couple up to the 49.
The tackle made.
They went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
Back to the workhorse today. It's Gurley. And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop him behind the line. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and nine.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're going to have to find a way to turn the page because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far, and it's cost them.
The Falcons on third down. It's been a problem. Just 1 for 7 thus far. This is third and nine. Gurley. And they'll get this across midfield, but not nearly close to a first down as he stopped at the 48. 3 yards won't be enough here as that'll bring up fourth down.
Well, the guys who are paid to make the tackles deserve some kudos there, but I think they deserve even bigger ones because in that situation, they had to be thinking pass. Loosened up defense, going to pass coverage. Instead, maybe they surprised them a little bit running the ball, yet they rallied to it and stopped them well short of a first down.
On fourth down, Ray.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pick. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line.
45-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead.
He's got a first down and then some inside the 40. And finally taken down at the 4-yard line. A big play there for the Panthers.
So that one, just a little touch pass, but it paid off quite handsomely.
Yeah, and let's face it, the quarterback loves it because it pads his stats as a completed pass for nice yardage downfield. But I like the way they get the receiver in motion. It's almost like he's running a route before he gets the football because he's got a full head of steam when the ball is popped in his direction.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal.
And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
No gain on the play. Leads to second and
they'll go again from the three here on second and goal.
Hey, check Mike 45. Check Mike 45. Target.
Again, McCaffrey. Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the one.
Short of the goal line.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a third time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
About a half yard from the end zone, third and goal.
Going to set him back 5 yards. How crucial will those 5 yards be? We'll see as they come up again here, third and goal. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of 2 there.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair.
So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. They've got a fourth down here in a game that looks to have been decided already. So it's 3 more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Gurley again here on first down.
And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40 before being taken down. That good for 22 and a first down.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
On first down, it's Gurley. And forget that 100-yard rushing game, at least for the moment, as he'll lose yardage here and fall back under the century mark for the game.
After seeing that, maybe time to go back to some downfield throws here.
Yeah, anything. Change it up, because the teams that win, the best teams, they're the ones that make adjustments. Doesn't mean you can't come back to what you thought you could get done. Sometimes when you open things up a little bit, you can get back to what you wanted to do before.
A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for Carolina, they did what they needed to do. They split their first two road games of the year.